Only you can make all this world seem right. Only you can make the darkness bright. Only you and you.
On this day 10 years ago, I sat awake in bed dreaming about being a dual-wielding orc in the brand new title Skyrim, set to release the next day. I didn't even go to school the next day. I sat at home waiting for my older brother to come home with a copy of the game for the Xbox 360. I had promised him that I would give him $30 from my Christmas money that following month if he would just pay for the other half, but the nice big brother he is, he bought it for me. I popped the disc in and literally cried with excitement as the opening scene rolled. I was finally awake. Fast forward 10 years, and I still have the same childlike wonder while playing Skyrim. At this point, I must have killed Alduin a good 50, maybe 60 times, and between these three, I've probably been married at least double that. But recently, on my yearly, oh hey, I forgot Skyrim existed, let me play that for 50 hours in 1 week, then not touch it until next year, binge, I got to thinking, there sure are a lot of characters in this game. I wonder if I've met them all by now. A quick Google search for the Skyrim wiki and I spent hours scrolling through and clicking on names that I didn't recognize. Most of the names were characters from DLC because I've only beaten Dawnguard like 3 times and the Dragonborn DLC only once, but there were definitely a large amount of characters in vanilla Skyrim that I hadn't met before. So obviously after seeing the sheer amount of characters in the game, I asked myself the next logical question. Do you think anyone has killed them all? I played some games with my friend the next day and asked him the same question, and he was fairly convinced that no, nobody had killed them all because it probably wasn't possible. I mean, obviously it isn't possible. Some characters you just literally can't kill. But with the use of a mod, would it be possible to kill every character in the game? Well, the answer simply is no. No, you cannot kill every character in the game. Oh, you're still here? Well, when I say you can't, I mean you can't kill them all because some characters respawn. If I go into Whiterun and kill every guard, in a matter of days the city will be full of new guards. I can kill them, but this process would go on forever. But would it be possible for me to kill every unique character? You know, every character with a name? I mean, sure, this is Bandit Chief and this is Master Vampire, but they aren't unique NPCs, there's plenty of them. But there's only one Ulfric, there's only one Tullius. There's only one Raelof. Well, okay, actually every Nord looks and sounds just like him, but you get my point. If I had a mod that allowed me to kill essential NPCs, could I kill them all? Well, that's what I'm here to find out today, so strap in, this is gonna be a long one. Also, I just quick wanna point out that someone already kind of did the same thing, but they didn't kill every NPC and in fact purposely left some alive. Mm-mm, not on my watch. First things first, I have to find out who all the NPCs are, what hold they're from, what their exact location is, and what classification they are, i.e. are they dogs, or children, or dragons, or anything else other than adult humanoids. So I gathered this huge list of every NPC using 2 different wikis, put them in alphabetical order, got all their information, and then sorted them into their respective holds. This took a while, but it was important that I was able to keep track of each individual NPC. Also, I just want to clear up right here that I am not doing DLC characters. This is the old version of Skyrim, I just want to kill vanilla characters. Once I had them all sorted, I had to come up with a plan to make sure I could actually encounter every NPC. What I mean by that is some NPCs are only available at certain times or during certain quests, so I had to find out what quests were associated with each NPC so I could figure out if any NPC was only available during a certain quest. Make sense? For example, you will never see Carlaya unless you do the Thieves Guild quest line. So in order to kill Carlaya, you need to do the Thieves Guild questline. In order to do the Thieves Guild questline, I can't kill any characters essential to the Thieves Guild questline. Have you heard me say Thieves Guild questline enough yet? With that in mind, I decided to go about this journey in 3 phases. I'll reveal the other 2 phases when we get there, but the first phase is the prep phase. In the prep phase, I need to go through all the quests that are essential to killing certain NPCs, starting, of course, with the main quest. If you're anything like me, that means you know the main quest like the back of your hand. Before we can get there, though, I need to make a character capable of killing every NPC in the game, and his name is Dump. You know, like Dumpy or Dumpy Kong, like that's my YouTube name, and you know, like my Twitch name. You can follow me on Twitch if you want. Just saying. Anyway, with the birth of Dump comes the death of Skyrim. Hard to sound dramatic with a name like Dump. To keep track of all the notable things that happen as I go, I got a notebook and just wrote down anything interesting that happened, especially the death of any unique NPC. We don't have to wait long for our first fatality as Lokir from Rorikstead tries to escape and is less than successful. You do have to make a decision shortly thereafter, where you can decide if you want to go with Raelof or Hadvar. Usually I would go with Raelof because Hadvar just tried to have me fucking killed, but I decided I would flip a coin this time around. Alright, what do we get? Stormcloak or Imperial? Are we racist or are we a pussy? Heads for Stormcloak, tails for Imperial, and coin says racist. After we get through Helgen, we reach our second fatality, Anise. Now, I'm not going to go through every individual kill because that would take fucking forever, but I've actually never seen Anise before, even though she's so close to Riverwood. Small world. Or, I guess, big world. Anyways, I know how this sack of shit game works, so I decided to get ahead of things and go straight to Bleak Falls Barrow to grab the Dragonstone and save myself some time. Unfortunately, I forgot to loot the Draugr Overlord to grab the stone, which means I actually wasted a lot of time instead of saving any. Good start to things. So I got to Whiterun, told Ballnuts about the dragon, and then realized while talking to Farengar that I forgot the tablet. I went back through Bleak Falls Barrow, oh yeah, killed Arvel by the way, and got the Dragonstone. Then some boring stuff happens, and boom, dragon time. I killed Mirmolnir, did I say that right? And then got yelled at by a bunch of old guys in the sky. I thought about bringing Lydia along for the ride, but ultimately decided against it. I didn't want to get too attached to anyone in this run, because everybody needs to die in the end. Next, I climbed 7,000 stairs to go meet the old assholes who yelled at me. Oh yeah, I killed this guy, felt really guilty about it. And while taking a carriage to Morthal, my game crashed. Go to old Skyrim. Eventually, I got to Ustengrav and the horn! It's gone! Whoever would have guessed. So I go and talk it up with Delphine, and end up killing the second named dragon, Solokinir. I think I got that one. I returned the horn of Jerkoff Windcaller and got my full-blown Fusroda. My next move might be a bit controversial. If you played Skyrim in the early days, you might remember all the YouTube videos talking about how to get certain skills maxed out by cheesing the system. Well, this is one such cheese. To get your sneak all the way leveled up, you just sit behind one of the Greybeards and punch them. A lot. And I did that until my sneak was level 80. Not just to level up my sneak, but to level up a bit in general. Anyways, it's time to fucking party. I went and bought some nice clothes, I got all dressed up, and then I realized I couldn't wear any of my new clothes. I had to wear clothes that were designated for the party. Lame. But the party is as lame as the clothes. That is, until I start killing people. Then it's fun. I made it through the embassy, killed a few nerds, killed this poor sack, and then made it out through a cave. While I was in said cave, writing notes in my notebook, this asshole attacked me. Bad. Bad asshole. After that party, I had to go party in the sewers. I found Lesburn. Get it? Like lesbian? Like Esburn, but lesbian. Like lesbian. Is this offensive? Anyways, I murdered the poor crazy people, and then it was off to be really fucking bored. This quest is fucking boring.
Look, here is Ulthuan.
I went back to the Greybeards. Arngar asked me a stupid question.
Where did you learn of that? Who have you been talking to?
Gee, man, I don't know. I'm not in a full suit of blades armor or anything. I finally met the ultimate homie, and he sent me off on another unbearable quest. While talking to the Jarl of Winterhold, I was attacked by two dragons at the same time. And then I went to jail because I accidentally shouted at someone. This is just not fair. Anyway, I was forced to go through these godforsaken ruins and get the Elder Scroll. I really hate these type of ruins. They're neat on your first couple rounds, but after being literally forced to go through this shit every time you want to beat the main quest, it gets a little old. I did some sick parkour. Was ambushed. But I made it to the end. At the end, there's this stupid puzzle. I never remember how you're supposed to do it, but with enough guessing, I got it. And I finally got the Elder Scroll. But now that I have the Elder Scroll, that means I have to get through the most painful part of the game. This cutscene. If you've played the game, I don't need to explain why this cutscene absolutely blows, but I made it through, and then had my epic showdown with Alduin, and hey, where are you going? Get back here! Pussy. Anyways, it's time for another party. A tea party.
I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
This sucks. Can I help you? The tea party goes well, everyone makes nice, and I get to play with a dragon. Mom, can I keep him? I went to go sell some stuff to Fartenhard before going off on my dragon slaying journey, but he was gone. I couldn't find him anywhere. I even waited a while to see if he would come to bed. Nope, gone. So I went back to the dragon and, oh, there he is. Of course he's with the dragon. So Oda Ving, I think I pronounced that right, took me to Skuldafin and then fucking dipped. Fair enough. I battled and guessed my way through and then ran like a pussy straight to Sovngarde. Now if you're smart, you'll realize that I really fucked up here. But if you're dumb, I'll let you suffer for a bit. But don't worry, I'll explain later. Here in Sovngarde, Alduin has nowhere else to escape, but before I battle him, I have to go recruit some dead old people. But before that, I have to get through Soon, or Sun, whatever. And let me tell you, this guy fucked me up. Literally killed me 9 times. After I got through that traumatizing ordeal, the actual boss fight wasn't too bad. They didn't need me. They didn't need these old bastards. They just needed Soon. But hey, Alduin is dead, and I am like, less than 1% through this shit. Next up, the Thieves Guild quest line. I figured I would start here instead of other quest lines because towards the end of it, you get the skeleton key. Now, you're supposed to put the skeleton key back where it belongs, but I figure I could just borrow it for a little while. The Thieves Guild nonsense isn't all that exciting, it's all fairly easy, lots of fetch quests, though it is always fun beating up women for their money. I also did the mission where you follow this guy, but in the middle of it, I scooted my chair back and hit my power strip, shutting my computer off and corrupting that recording. Didn't really miss much, but now I'm in Snowvale with Mercer and— aww, dang it. Now I'm asleep. Also, fuck Mercer. All my homies hate Mercer. In the end though, Mercer was no match and he was left to die as he lived. Like a bitch. Also, I think I'm a Satanist now. Not really sure how that happened. Anyway, that pretty much wraps up the Thieves Guild questline, and it was at this point that I decided maybe I needed a friend. You see, we're some minutes through this video, but I was about 9 hours into this playthrough. It was starting to get lonely. So like any responsible genocidal maniac, I bought a house, got it fully furnished, and then put a wife in it.
We're married. Blessed by Mara's divine grace.
Is it irresponsible to get married to someone I know I'll have to murder in cold blood later? Yep, will come back to bite me. So next up, I'm gonna do the College of Winterhold questline. No real reason for picking this questline to be second, just gotta get through them all. Apparently, I really didn't have fun in Sarthal because in my notes I wrote, "Under Sarthal is such a dogshit quest," and apparently I didn't have fun looking for the lost books you need to find because I later wrote, "This questline sucks." I guess you could say I'm a glass half full kind of guy. I met the Augur of Dunlane, still really not sure what the fuck this guy's all about, and was off to do some more things that I will inevitably complain about. I ended up having to do another fucking puzzle, and then murdered the man who helped me because I was frustrated. It's also part of my job. I tried to go back to the college, but this guy wanted to smoke weed, so fine, that's cool. But when I got back, Ancano was being a major dick. Ancano nuked us, and unfortunately, well, fortunately I guess for the sake of the video, the Archmage didn't survive. Did have some sick moves though. I ended up in Labyrinthian, and after cheesing the skeletal dragon, I beat the shit out of Maroki to not only get the Staff of Magnus, but Maroki's cool mask. I always love the Dragon Priest masks, they just make me feel so cool. So it's back to school time, and that means it's time to murder Ancano. But yeah, with Ancano dead, that's pretty much it for the College of Winterhold quests. This questline really doesn't last too long or is too complicated, and I get to be the Archmage.
Here, consider these yours.
After being at the school for like all of 3 hours. Cool. Next up, the Dark— The Bard's College. The Bard's College is really only like a couple small quests, so it's super fast, but I couldn't exactly remember if it was necessary to encounter any NPCs, so I figured I'd get it out of the way. Truly nothing noteworthy, although this part where you make up the missing King Olaf verse is so cool. I wish there were more unique quests in the game like this. Alright, next up, the Dark— The Forsworn Conspiracy. Believe it or not, I have not actually ever completed this quest before. I've started it, but I got bored and just never finished it, so this'll be my first time. You get a note from this guy, you meet up with the guy, you throw hands with this guy, and all of a sudden, I'm killing people. Holy shit, what happened? I go meet up with the guy again, and oh.
Now you have to pin all these recent murders on you. Silence witnesses. Work, work, work.
They threw me in jail? This is the best quest of all time! How have we never done this before? You best believe I'm not staying in this shithole, so I get out through the Markarth ruins with the help of Madinac and his gang of nerds, and we break out into the city. Seriously, this quest is wild. So they fight their way through the city, and I assume that this is where most people part ways with their fellow prisoners, but I decided I'd follow them to see where they go. They ran and ran and ran, but I got impatient, so I started swinging. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 more names off the list. Next up, it's Dark Brotherhood time. Oh wait, really? To start this questline, we have to go meet up with a sad little boy who wants this old lady dead. Well, he asked nicely, so now she's dead. Man, murdering old ladies sure does make me sleepy. Would be a shame if a hot murdering skin tight suit wearing woman kidnapped me. I learned recently that you can use clairvoyance to find which target you're supposed to kill, so I did that. I probably should have killed them all because this video is literally titled I Killed Every NPC in Skyrim. Well, I guess I lied. I got some lame looking armor, and now it's time to start working for the man. Well, killing for the man. Well, okay, it's time to start killing for the woman. That sounds right. Damn, Astrid? More like Astrid. Heyo! That hurt me. After a while, this stinky little man starts having schizophrenic episodes in which he talks to a rotten corpse and— oh shit, is this rotten corpse talking to me? I'm the listener, huh? I'm the Dragonborn, the Archmage, the leader of the Thieves Guild, I think. And now, the listener. I might be a little too special. Like, suspiciously special. Anyway, I have some more people to murder. Man, all this murdering has made me tired. I think I'll take a break. Holy shit, where am I? So I may have taken a much longer break than intended, but I'm back and I'm ready to kill. This weirdo asked me to murder a lady on what should have been the happiest day of her life, but he did ask nicely, so... No! After that, I'm instructed to kill Commander Morrow's son, Gaius, and I did. I'm starting to kill some people in high places. I'm sure that won't come back to bite me. I got back to the sanctuary to find out that the little man is finally cracked. Apparently he started swinging at people and now it's my job to go kill him. Of course it is. It's always my fucking job. I hunted him down, killed the ghosts protecting him, and finally came face to face with him. I killed Cicero, did some looting, and oh no, I know where this is going.
A new hand touches the beacon.
Yeah. After all that, it's time to kill the big man himself, the Emperor. To do that, I have to find the gourmet, so I can impersonate him, infiltrate the castle, and poison the Emperor. I met with Anton, who told me where I could find the gourmet, and then I killed him. And his wife. I'm not crazy. So I found the gourmet, I killed him, and then his body glitched and got stuck, so I couldn't even hide him. Now it's time for another fun and unique quest, making the stew for the Emperor. You have a choice between a normal ingredient and a weird ingredient, and I figured because everyone will be dead soon anyways, I might as well just use all the weird ones. Gianna serves the gourmet his stew, if you can really even call it that, and he dies. We did it! Time to escape! We didn't do it. Well, turns out Commander Morrow wasn't thrilled that I murdered his son, and he decided he would take down all of the Dark Brotherhood for revenge. What a monster he is. So I killed his goons and got back to the sanctuary, but by the time I got there, everybody was either dead or dying. The whole place falls apart and I have to cuddle with that rotting corpse I talked about earlier, also known as the Night Mother, and when I wake up, the flames have settled. Turns out Astrid is alive, kinda, and asked me to finish her off. Makes me sad, but of course I will. Shit, that's embarrassing. Even with Astrid dead, I still have to complete the contract to kill the Emperor. No poison, no impersonating, just some good old hack and slash murder. I destroy everyone on board his ship and then meet the actual Emperor. Honestly, he's pretty chill, but I do still have to kill him. With him dead, my contract is complete. Motier told me where my money is, and then I killed that slimy bastard. I totally forgot about Rexis though, Motier's bodyguard. Sick work, by the way. But don't worry, I'll get him later. I got my money, and for now, that's all I really need to do. I don't want to kill Nazir or Babette quite yet because I actually like them, and I also haven't turned on the mod that lets me kill everyone yet, so I doubt I even could. But as far as the Dark Brotherhood goes, that's pretty much it. Next in line, the Companions. This is a questline I don't usually go all the way through because I don't really like being a werewolf, but for this run, I really have no choice. So I meet up with the Companions, and it's a fairly fun questline. Lots of fighting, lots of killing, you know, just boy stuff. Eventually, Farkas reveals his fursona and asks me to join him. I do, reluctantly, and I myself am now a furry. Super long story short, I do some stuff, kill some people, Codlac dies by the way, and free the spirit of Codlac. As far as big quest lines go, that's about it. The Dark Brotherhood, the College of Winterhold, Thieves Guild, and the Companions are all kind of the big ones. So at this point, I just have to get through all the smaller quests and take out all the people I mentioned earlier who only appear as part of a quest. Some of those names include, but are not limited to, Thorold Grimman, Melkoran, Draskua, Gunzel, Silas Vizvizvizvizvizvizviz, Jakir, Rissing, Safaruna, Cindy, Torkoal the Fearsome, Yar Gro Gatuk, Mad Tassar, Bottom Grabbar. Your name's Bottom. There's a lot of people here in this section, but that's because there's a lot of quests to get through. Some of my favorites are the Cursed Tribe and Rise in the East, and my least favorites are Blood on the Ice and A Dangerous Best Friend. After a good dozen or so quests, I figured I would do some Dark Brotherhood contracts to kill some people and get paid for it. So, I suited up in my stealth suit and... Lydia, dude, you ruined my shot.
Get the fuck out of the... Fuck you.
I went on a couple quests, but it turns out that these people aren't named people, they're just generic NPCs, so I don't really need to do these. In hindsight, I think you can get some actual, like, real NPC contracts from Nazir, but I didn't even think to ask him, so I guess I'll go back to what I was doing. I got the Ebony Blade from the Whispering Door quest, and I really didn't, still don't, know what it does, so I grabbed Feyndall to test it on him, and, didn't do anything. Poor Feyndall. I also was doing the Taste of Death quest, and while I was about to murder Brother Valululis, I accidentally hit Eola, and then everybody attacked me, and now they're dead. Whoops. I brought this girl to the Temple of Dibella, I summoned an actual demon, who I killed, I made a new friend because I couldn't kill him and I didn't want him to escape, I killed a vampire, Whoa.
Prank him, John!
I killed a spirit lady, and finally, I got around to killing the dragon priests. It was at this point that I realized the mistake I had made earlier. Well, you see, there's a dragon priest right before you enter Sovngarde, Nokrin, and because I blew right by him, I obviously didn't kill him, and there's no conventional way to get back to Skuldafin, which means I fucked up. I fucked up bad. But, like, he's kind of already dead, right? Like, he's just a reanimated corpse, right?
Hey, Editor John here. Look, I actually did spawn Nokrin in with a console command and killed him, but I forgot to record it. But here's a little screenshot of me with the mask, putting it away in my chest in my house. So I did kill him. Yeah, technically. Technically.
My failure aside, I'm pretty much ready for phase 2 of my master plan. Phase 2. Slaughter. This phase is exactly what it sounds like. This is the point where I will wipe out a vast majority of Skyrim's characters. Before I do that, though, I need a mod. If you know me, you know I'm a little reckless and don't actually prepare for things very well, and that can definitely be applied in this situation because I didn't actually have a mod ready to use. I assumed I could just look up a mod that would allow me to kill all NPCs, hit a button, beep boop bop, and I could commit genocide. Well, turns out it ain't that easy. Like I said earlier, I'm using the old version of Skyrim, and I guess not a lot of people are making or even maintaining mods for this version of the game. I found some mods, but some didn't work, and the other ones all require you to have DLC. Well, I didn't have the DLC, so I actually had to buy the DLC for the old version of Skyrim, which you can't even do on Steam. So I purchased the DLC through a third party, and was finally able to get a mod working. I had to go to this room, click this button, and then wait around for all the characters to be marked as non-essential. And once all the NPCs were fired up and ready to kill, I had to test it out.
Nasty business with that.
I started in Winterhold, the smallest of the holds, and just killed everyone I could. I killed the people in the college, I killed the people in the inn, I even went and killed the Jarl and his lackeys. I've never really been a huge fan of Winterhold, so this really wasn't very emotional, I was just kind of having fun with it. When all was said and all was done, I had killed pretty much all the characters in the entire hold, and it was time to move on. Next up on the chopping block, Morthal. Morthal really didn't put up much of a fight, and after that was Dawnstar. Like the others, I don't really care about Dawnstar, and I really didn't feel all that bad. Sure, I was literally killing an entire city, but I was more worried about my cinematography. After Dawnstar, I hit Falkreath. Now, I'm sure you've noticed by now that things are really starting to pick up in speed. I've gone from a stray couple kills in certain quests, to massacring entire cities,
But that's why I made this a whole phase. To kill every NPC in the game, I'm gonna need these huge kill counts. After Falkreath, I moved on to a much bigger town, Riften. I'm not sure if Riften is actually much bigger in overall size than the other cities, but it's definitely more populated. Not only do I have to kill the NPCs outside, at the blacksmith, and in the local inn, but I need to kill all the kids in this orphanage, all the people in this temple, and all the people in Mistvale Keep. Not to mention an entire guild. I actually got chased by Imperial soldiers into the cistern, and my fellow thieves helped me fight them off, but little did they know, I was their real enemy. I killed them all, and then made my way to the Ragged Flagon. Just like the others, these thieves were absolutely no match. It started at this point to weigh on me that I was killing so many NPCs that I knew and liked. Like, killing Vex just felt so wrong. I mean, she was one of my favorite characters. Granted, that is mostly because she made my 12-year-old wiener hard. But it still kinda hurt my soul to see all the Thieves Guild dead. It felt just as wrong to kill characters like Mjoll or Edda, who really had done nothing to me in the last 10 years to deserve this. Unfortunately for me, the weight of my conscience would only get heavier as I went on. With Riften in ashes, I next went to Markarth. Markarth is another city that I was never particularly attached to, but man did they beat my ass. I think the Stormcloaks here actually killed me twice. Once the guards were gone though, the rest of the city really stood no chance. Even the Jarl and those around him fell pretty easy. Putting these dogs down was by far the most difficult part. There is a metric ass ton of NPCs in Markarth, and I knew I didn't get them all, but don't worry, I'll come back to them. After Markarth, I didn't have a whole lot of options left, so I went to Solitude next. My guess was that Solitude was going to be the most difficult city to take over because it's very wide open, and there's this entire section that's usually full of guards, but even they didn't stand a chance. I fought through all the guards and started picking off all the characters I could. Some characters felt great to kill, but most didn't. I especially felt bad for killing everyone in the Blue Palace. The Jarl and her aides fell pretty easy, and just like that, the Blue Palace was silent. I wiped out the Bard's College and Castle Dower and was left alone in the city. No kids playing tag, no vendors selling their goods, no guards training, no blacksmiths, blacksmithing, just me and my sins. The next city to fall was Windhelm. I don't care for Windhelm as much as I do for Riften and Solitude, but I was still uneasy about killing everyone. I actually don't even know the city that well, so I kept getting lost. I think the most insane part of fighting Windhelm was the Palace of Kings. Ulfric, Galmar, and the rest of the people in the palace put up a good fight, but in the end, they all fell too. This game starts off with you in a carriage with the recently arrested Ulfric because he killed High King Torrig with his Thum. Unfortunately for him though, his voice was no match for mine. With Windhelm gone, there's only one capital city left, Whiterun. Whiterun is easily my favorite city. It's where I spend most of my time playing Skyrim. Quick aside here, I was a nerdy little teenager, so of course I would be roleplaying. After I killed Nokarin, I would take his mask and then I would wear his mask around while I was adventuring. Then, when people would see me with the mask, they would know that I was gonna kill them. Like, I had this whole thing where I would take my mask off before going into the city so that people wouldn't know it was me. And if anybody saw me with my mask on, I would kill them. I know it's nerdy, but it's just one of the many reasons that I love this game so much. And for now at least, I couldn't bring myself to kill everyone in Whiterun. Not yet. My cowardice aside, I decided to move on to the Orc strongholds. I also thought that they would put up more of a fight, but once again, I was wrong. They all went down pretty easy. I actually forgot an entire stronghold, but I'll come back to that. After some racially charged killing, I hit some smaller cities. Dragonbridge, Karthwaston, Rorikstead, Iverstead, Kynesgrove, and Riverwood all fell. Riverwood really hurt. I think the first girl I ever married in this game was Camilla, so killing her and her brother really hurt. Every character in the city really took a toll, but especially Stump. I won't make you watch it, but just trust me when I say that it really hurt to kill Stump. With these cities done, I really had no choice but to take on Whiterun. No more stalling. There's a moon out tonight. Let's go strolling. Strolling through the park. There. Whiterun emptied out, I was done with Phase 2. I killed approximately 333 unique characters in this phase. Hopefully you see why I called it the Slaughter Phase. After completing this phase, I really felt like there was like a dark cloud around me. It just felt bad. Again, I know they're not real people, but they still mattered, to me at least. So with all those characters dead, and so many killed in the first phase, what's left? Well, Phase 3. Cleanup. For Phase 3, I went back into my spreadsheet, sorted out all the remaining characters into their respective holds, I wrote it all down in my notebook, and then crossed them off as I killed them. I tried to go through each hold in the order I killed their capitals, starting with Winterhold. Winterhold is easily the smallest hold, and there was really only 7 people left for me to kill. After killing those 7, I had successfully cleared out my first entire hold. You could walk anywhere in Winterhold, and not find one single unique NPC. It was sort of scary. The second hold to get eradicated was Hjalmarch, or Northall's hold. Hjalmarch has a good chunk more characters, a strong 18 compared to Winterhold 7, but like Winterhold, there wasn't much of a fight. Not that I was expecting it to be hard, most of the remaining characters are all spread out and some are alone, making it much easier to kill them. But killing Miko, that will haunt me for the rest of my life. Like I said, I'm going in order, so next is the Pale, or Dawnstar's hold. The Pale only had 14 characters for me to kill. Nazir is easily one of the most homey characters in the game, so it really sucked to kill him. After the Pale should have been Falkreath. I say should have because I forgot to do it. I must have just flipped 2 pages of my notebook over to the rift and just blanked on Falkreath. I came back to it later though. I think it had about 13 characters left. Like I said though, I went to the rift next. Now this is where we start getting some big boy numbers. In the rift, I had about 60 or so characters left to kill. And I did. I had to go back through Riften and find a bunch of characters that I forgot about, but eventually, I got them all. Next hold, the Reach, Markarth's hold. Some characters in this hold were new to me, but there were some familiar faces like Esbern and Delphine. I think the Reach had about 40 people left for me to find, but now it has 0. Hafengar, or Solitude's hold, is another big one. Hafengar had almost 60 people for me to kill. I think one of the areas here that hit me the hardest was Kotla's farm. It's just a little farm with a pretty large family, and now they're dead. Dead because I killed them. This video is not as much fun as I thought it would be. It did feel good to kill Elenwen though, because she's a fucking bitch. I also cleared out Mor'Kazgur here, which is the orc stronghold I forgot earlier. Oh wait, shit, I forgot Narzalbur too. Well, that brings me to our next hold, Eastmarch. Eastmarch was a real pain in my ass, specifically Windhelm. I said it earlier and I'll say it again, I keep getting lost. I literally don't know shit about this city, and believe it or not, I still don't know shit about this city. It took me a while to clear out the whole town because in Windhelm alone I had about 14 people unaccounted for. I got them all though, even found out that this lady killed herself. Must have heard I was coming to town. And if you think that's sad, wait till you hear the next part. So one of the quests in the game is called Boethia's Calling. In this quest, you have to bring a follower to an altar and sacrifice them. Sounds dark, right? Well, yeah, it is. I would normally never do this quest because betraying a follower makes my heart hurt, but I had to do this quest so I could kill both the Priestess of Boethia and the Champion of Boethia, an NPC you can only reach by completing the second phase of this quest. So fine, I have to kill everyone. Might as well grab a random follower and sacrifice them, right? Well, again, yeah. But here's the problem. Every follower I can think of is dead. I literally could not think of one person left that I could complete this quest with. That is, except for one.
Lead the way.
Lydia. As a kid, I would get mad at Lydia, so I would take her up to the throne of the world and Fusroda her off the mountain. She's an essential NPC, so it's not like it would matter. I wasn't really killing her because she couldn't die. But now, she can, and she has to. I have to kill Lydia to complete this challenge, and I also need someone to complete for this quest. So, I did it. No joke, I really felt like an absolute monster. Slaughtering hundreds of people took its toll for sure, but this one hit me like a train. With Lydia dead, Boethia would enter her body and instruct her followers to kill each other. The last one standing would face her champion. I wanted to kill them all, take out the sadness I felt on them, but I couldn't. I just watched as they mindlessly killed each other. Again, I'm sure it sounds ridiculous, but this entire thing took a mental toll on me. I just felt bad. I know they're not real people, but like I said at the start of the video, I've been playing this game for 10 years. I am 22 years old. I'm bad at math, but that is a significant amount of time to be playing one game. At least once a year, I would get into the game, have the time of my life, and then rediscover it all the next year, but now I just felt sad. I didn't really want to play it anymore. As the last warrior ran at me to kill me, I didn't even want to fight. I just blew them down the hill. There was one person I could take the anger out on, though. The champion of Boethia. If it wasn't for this dick, I would have at least been able to kill Lydia in a much nicer way, like the Emperor or Astrid. But no, I had to sacrifice her so a demon could take over her body. This guy was gonna pay. And pay he did. I killed him and took the ebony mail, a trophy given by Boethia to her champion, but to me it was sort of a mark of shame. It was like a suit full of my sins, like all the people I killed were surrounding me and slowly poisoning anyone unfortunate enough to have to fight me. I know I'm taking this all way too seriously, but I really can't help but feel bad. After finishing this quest, I had to finish clearing out the hold of Whiterun, which was another task I wasn't looking forward to. I had about 40 people left in this hold, and I got them all, one by one. I sniped a Lava because I really didn't want to face her, I helped Goldir prevent his family from being defiled, and then of course betrayed him right after. I killed several farmers, and I actually missed killing someone in Riverwood. Oh yeah, Hod. Here's his house, and oh shit, is that Raeloth? Well, I had to kill Raeloth too. Honestly, I forgot he was here, but after finishing them off, I was done with Whiterun as well. Every NPC in every hold was dead. There was one issue I ran into here though. There were still some characters remaining. In fact, there were 6 more characters who you only met through random encounters. They don't actually exist in the world unless they're randomly triggered to run into you, so technically it didn't matter if I killed them or not. But I decided I would fight them, as I wanted to be as thorough with this challenge as I could. I went back to the Sicilum of Boethia, and through console commands, spawned in characters I had to fight. I first killed Balbus, a character whose life dream was to meet the Gourmet. I then killed Botar and San together as they were encountered together. Then I killed Deep in his cups, weird name, but I really can't judge with a name like Dumpy Kong. I then killed Faldris, a dark elf who would normally be encountered on his travels to the Shrine of Azura. And finally, for the random encounters, I killed the one and only, Maik the Liar. Maik is a fan favorite, and I can see why, being in both Oblivion and Skyrim, but he was no match. And that's it for random encounters, but there was still one more character I needed to get rid of, Oda Ving. There's no conventional way to summon him other than to use his shout, and my impression is that if I do kill him with this mod, he'll just clone himself next time you use the shout. So I just spawned him in with console commands and killed him that way. He really didn't want to fight, but really, it wasn't much of a fight. With those 7 characters dead, I had truly killed every NPC in Skyrim. That is, except for 5. The last NPCs remaining are, of course, the Greybeards and their master, Parthenax. I saved them for last because they are truly the staples of Skyrim. I have never, not once in all of my playthroughs of this game, killed Parthenax. You see, after killing Alduin, Delphine tells you that Parthenax deserves to die. Technically, a long time ago, he was a bad guy. He's Alduin's brother, and way back in their heyday, Parthenax fought alongside Alduin. So you have the option to either leave Parthenax to live out his life, or you can go and kill him. I always just let him be because not only did he help me defeat Alduin, but he's just an overall wise and nice guy. He's learned from his mistakes and has kept the way of the voice going for years by teaching the Greybeards. But now, the time has come for me to finish this challenge. I'll have to kill the Greybeards, and then I'll have to kill Parthenax. This truly is the end. I made my way up the 7,000 steps to High Hrothgar. Not sprinting, just walking. I wanted to go as slow as I could, as I really wasn't looking forward to this. As I walked, I could see Parthenax circle the mountain above. It was like he knew what was coming. I killed some creatures on the way up the mountain, but by now it just felt like drops, not in the bucket, but in the ocean. I finally reached High Hrothgar and stood outside for a moment, taking in a time when I hadn't yet killed the Greybeards. I entered, knowing full well that I couldn't just go in swinging like crazy. I had to fight them like a coward if I was gonna beat them, because if they fought me all together, I stood no chance. So that's what I did. I used Maroon's Razor, and one by one, I killed each member of the Greybeards. I finally approached Arngar while he slept, and attacked him too. He, however, was not going down without a fight. He got up and froze me with a shout, and watched as I lay still. I was frozen for a good minute or so, but while I was frozen, Arngar was actually losing the battle. Like I said earlier, the amalgamation of my crimes, the ebony mail, poisons the enemies around you. So while I lay on the ground helpless, the armor fought for me. By the time I was able to move, I had practically won. The suit finished off Arngar, and the Greybeards were defeated. After defeating my masters, I made my way up the rest of the mountain. I could have fast traveled, but like before, I didn't want to get there. I didn't want to finish off the last remaining character in this world, but ultimately, I did. With Parthenax dead, I had truly completed the challenge. There is one last character, though. I know it got kind of dark there at the end, but thank you all for watching. I really appreciate your patience as I've been working on this video for the past like several months and haven't really had time to work on much else. I did manage to get two other videos out since the time I started working on this video, so if you enjoyed this, you should go check those videos out too. I really don't recommend that anyone else do this genocide run, as it really did take a mental toll on me, not just because it took so long, but because I really like Skyrim and I want to be able to play it for 10 more years. But after this run, I'm not sure if I'll be able to play it the same. By the end of this whole thing, I had killed roughly 800 unique NPCs, and over 1800 total NPCs. Anyway, I really appreciate you watching. If you made it all the way through, comment "All my homies hate Mercer." I usually hide a "comment if you see this message" sort of thing in my videos, but I figured I'd save this one for the end. With that, I really have nothing else. Thank you for being here, and thank you Skyrim for 10 great years. GG's everybody.